What's up, Slackers? Welcome back to Slackcast for another episode of our E3 2016 coverage, where we are talking about the, like, field of dreams of fucking game press conferences, in my opinion.
So wildly depressing?
No, but, like, the good part. Like, after they build the baseball field and he reconnects with his dad and stuff.
Spoiler alert!
Spoilers for Field of Dreams, everybody. Pull your shirt down, you filthy fucking animal.
Spoilers for this video, you're gonna see Spaz's belly button several times.
We're talking about Sony's press conference. It was fucking hot fire. They
spit hot fire on.
They kicked
our nylon.
They kicked off... Andy Brown, don't.
Unpopular opinions, Andy Brown all over the shit.
You're fine. You're
wrong.
Yeah.
Wrong. You're allowed to be wrong. That's
you're
going to
be as wrong as Spaz was in every other one of these videos. All
right, let's go God of War.
Yeah, so they kicked it off with the new God of War. Let's fucking watch it.
Yeah.
Spoiler alert,
it looks like God of War.
Well, that's not even true.
It really looks more like...
It looks more like a fucking... I don't even know what game it was.
Hey, my childhood.
Yeah? Smacking rocks together?
No,
yeah.
Man. That's different.
Wearing furs.
Wait. Can you clearly not tell that that is clearly two different religions right there of pantheons that they're representing? Come on.
Yeah.
Yeah. Said rocks. They're not rocks. They're
like...
They're
it's one religion's rock god,
god
and the other religion's rock
icons
god.
Of deities
magic
are
rocks.
Not rocks.
The cross is just sticks. Whatever.
He's nailed right
I
in.
I wonder what I do with this.
Anyway,
yeah.
So there's a Norse theme for this one. Pretty cool.
If you haven't heard, it's still Kratos.
Here's our boy Kratos.
Yeah.
Oh, he's old.
And his dad beard, old man Kratos. This boy calls him father, so I guess it's his son or maybe his adopted son.
And he does say that.
I hear this one gives you a whole hour before Kratos accidentally kills his adopted son.
Probably.
Well, it's not in the intro cinematic, so we're already a step ahead.
Hey, he needs some reason to get angry and kill all the gods, right?
The other thing is, his skin's already covered. I don't know how much more ash he can fit.
Yeah, that's a good point.
He's already getting, you know, he's got his war paint.
I mean,
so.
So wait, so is God of War, like, 5, he's just gonna go and, like, kill Chinese gods?
I mean,
this is God of War 5. So in 6...
Well, is he just gonna like?
No, they're gonna do
all the gods from all the religions.
They're gonna do like 6 games where he kills all the Norse gods, and
right.
then they'll probably
be a trilogy.
And then he'll kill Jesus.
That would be awesome. I would love to see a game where you play as Kratos and you have to kill Jesus.
Blasphemers!
And then fight your way to heaven and murder God.
I mean, good luck. He can resurrect. So.
Yeah, we. Well, we
Jesus gets resurrected like 6 times. Like,
right.
Fucking come at me, Kratos.
Yeah.
but yeah, so I mean, like, the game looks a lot more open than any of the other ones?
Definitely. I'm taking the camera perspective of this one.
Yeah.
A lot better than the other ones.
It's...
I wonder how they're going to explain how he doesn't have any powers.
What do you mean? Who says he doesn't have powers?
Well, he's killed off every part of...
Poser for pussies!
He's killed off every part of the pantheon, and aww. In the second and third game, when he got his powers from the Titans, like, they're dead too, so... It's like... He's kind of just a god.
He still has powers, though.
Well, yeah,
at least they show him use that axe on his back, and it's definitely magic.
Well, I mean, that could just be the axe.
Yeah.
You know. He was gifted godly weapons before he was a god.
Also, I just real quick, I didn't realize this the first time we saw this.
Yeah.
I was just watching Kratos' face.
Right.
They individually are animating his fucking beard flowing in the wind, and it's beautiful.
Here we go. This is what the real fun part is. Mmm.
Yup. Frost axe, baby.
See, that's not like his... You know, that's just an axe that happens to be magic.
But yeah, even this, like, this combat looks a lot different. Like,
yeah.
It's less quick timey.
And it looks good.
Yeah, it looks tight.
Yeah.
You'd have to do, like, square button, like, 20 times to get them to the... Like, this part's amazing, by the way. This is just...
Ugh.
Come on. I don't have an axe. I don't need it.
This is why
I like Viking stuff.
Dude, it's literally just as brutal as ever.
But yeah, I was, I don't know, I was never really
huge
into the God of War games, but, I mean, just, like, from a presentation
I really enjoyed them,
really cool.
Honestly, just because, like, they were kind of like Devil May Cry. I liked
they were
too.
Just, like, fun hacking.
The gameplay was fun. Kratos as a character really bothered me.
The story was whatever.
I mean,
yeah. Kratos' entire, like, every single thing is just like,
Oh, I figured it out, guys. Story beats of this game.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to do some stuff. The kid's going to get hit by lightning. He's going to swear a vendetta against Thor. The other Norse gods are going to come to Thor's defense. He's going to kill all of them.
I mean, this is a frost giant, so that's cool. To segue out of that.
I wonder if instead of him, like, fighting the gods, like, can you imagine if he, like, actually, like, ends up, like, working with them or something?
Dude, maybe
like,
it's Ragnarok.
Trying to go to Valhalla or something.
No, maybe it's Ragnarok and he's stopping it.
That's a blasphemy against everything God of War is.
Well, no, what if Odin died and he's, like, the last defender of all that, you know, and everything's gonna fall apart?
Like, it's a different Kratos,
no,
though,
this
man.
Kind of he's got, like, a Dark Souls.
No, I
don't
mean, like, a different character. I mean, like, Kratos is in a different place in his life. He's got, like, a new son.
He's not the God of War now, so the best part is that he's probably a little more sensible in his old age.
Thompson,
yeah.
look at this fighting system.
Yes. A little bit of Dark Souls-esque, or Bloodborne.
Right?
More like Bloodborne, really.
Yeah.
What I think's cool is that there are no quick time events.
So far.
I don't know.
Yeah, no,
I
like
I appreciated, like, God of War's fucking quick time events boss battle where the boss was the fucking level.
Yeah, that's true. Cool.
Those were really fucking cool. I would be upset if that didn't come back in some capacity.
Quick time events have their place.
They're fun, like Dead Space, when you had the needle going through your eye and the table. I don't know if you guys ever played that, but there's this 2-foot-long spike that you're laying on the table, and it just you have to get it perfectly into your eyeball.
Is he
going to
use his Spartan Rage? Spartan Rage!
See, that's not like a power. That's just him getting pissed. Like, that's not godly power. Look, he's mad as fuck. Look at this. He's mad, dude. He's just angry. Yeah,
oh my God.
That's what I'm talking about.
The people's elbow.
You
Kratos,
it.
Now
you
voiced by Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
I would kill for that.
You fucking piece of shit.
Come on, man.
And look at him, no rage.
Look at this, he's like, I got this. I don't even need your stupid bow.
It's like, whatever.
He gave that kid a chance to fail just so he could look more badass when he did it and took the arrow out. And this is the best part of this whole thing right here. This kid. Yeah, we know. But. Oh. Best dad ever!
What
did
he say?
The deer is getting away. He doesn't let the kid apologize and get, like, caught up in his emotion that he missed the shot and shot his, like, adopted father. Like, you know, could have killed him and all that. He's like, dude, you're hunting a deer. Don't forget about this shit. Like, stays on target. Good parenting, 101.
No, I do have to say, like, just in this little bit, we see more character development for Kratos in this 10 minutes of footage than we did in all, like, 5 previous God of War games.
Definitely.
It's basically like when Master Chief finally started talking, and they're like, whoa, he's got 2 lines in the intro? What? Oh my god.
Yeah, that's like the...
That's got the bulk of it.
Yeah, essentially the climax of it that's, like, I think relevant just because it shows us a little bit about this Kratos, or where Kratos is at, is that... they go back, they find the deer, his son gets a shot on it, and then he, like, makes him, like...
The son, like, regrettably ends his life, and it's just like, ugh, man.
Yeah, he like, can't, like, bring himself to kill
that.
It, so he helps him drive the blade in,
yeah.
And then he, like, goes for this moment where he wants to, like, put his hand on him and, like, console him, but he, like, doesn't, and he's kind of, like, has this, like, moment of doubt, and I was just like, oh, wow, looks like Kratos might actually be a character, so...
Top that off, you see in the distance lightning in the clouds, and a... Dragon comes flying.
Yeah,
at them.
Dragon flies over them and shit.
Makes no sense to me on that part because I know mythology pretty well and I don't remember really the dragon part. But okay.
Yeah. So
I mean, Beowulf was Norse legend, wasn't it?
Yeah.
No,
Beowulf was
Saxon
shit.
Yeah, Saxon.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
Okay.
Well,
so that's God of War. It looks good. It looks good.
It's definitely not the same God of War, and that's the best step that they could have done. Because if it was just like the old ones, I wouldn't be excited.
Yeah, it would just be more of the
same.
Like,
oh, look, reskin. Look at that. You're in Norse lands now. But no, now it's its own thing. It's cool. Looks good.
Okay, so the next thing they did...
It was like when they redid Devil May Cry. And it was actually a new kind of Devil May Cry. While still feeling like the old one.
So here is the next big game that they announced. Was called Days Gone, which I was super excited about. Because it is the new game by Sony Bend, which is one of Sony's first-party studios. They were responsible for doing a lot of, like, their big Vita games. Like, they did the Uncharted game that was on Vita. Yeah, right.
Rest in peace, Vita.
That's, like, the year. This was the year of, like, RIP Vita. But, so this is, like, their first AAA game, and it's the first game that they've done in, like, several years. So it's been gestating for a really long time. It's pretty cool to actually see something of it.
Also, just so you know ahead of time, we are going to be showing a decent amount of trailers because they were fucking awesome.
Yeah,
the trailers
were so good.
Sony's was just
They had so much to
even
show.
Even if Andy doesn't like
it. Like what I said in the last episode, Microsoft was an A. This is like an S.
Wow. Fuck you.
That's a shit rank system. Right.
Oh, my
Monster Rancher rule. Monster Rancher rules.
S ranks.
Spaz, you made him salty. Like, come on.
So, yeah, essentially, this whole voiceover that we're talking over is this guy essentially lamenting the fall of society. And saying how he remembered seeing the world collapse in front of him.
If you played The Last of Us,
it's
like the same kind of intro.
Yeah.
Things are slowly falling apart, and it's probably a decade after some apocalyptic type event.
Right. That's kind of the one thing that I think is unfortunate, is like I am really excited about this game, but I feel like it's going to be written off because it's like, oh, another apocalyptic survival thing.
Which I'm totally
what if
fine
the
with
real monsters are us?
I'm fine with it because it's original.
Yeah, I am too, just because it looks good.
I mean, hey, you know, the other one, even in The Last of Us, you know, you play Joel, right? You're a pretty badass guy, but you don't want to be that badass all the time. This guy looks like he doesn't give a shit as much.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know, dude. So yeah, it seems like there's like the CDC or something, so like it seems like this whole, there's like a disease or something, maybe.
Well, if you see some of the gameplay.
Yeah.
I mean, this guy kind of just looks like a knockoff from Sons of Anarchy.
Yeah, no, no.
Sons
it's
of PlayStation.
It's definitely. You definitely just like
Nike.
The Sons
yeah
of Anarchy biker guy.
You're just like a biker
yeah
who like has become a mercenary in this new world, and like that's the game apparently.
Mercenary. Mm-hmm.
A mercenary. Metal Gear.
I am. Yeah. Nano Machine.
I am Solid Snake.
So yeah, Days Gone.
I'm interested in it because of the pedigree behind it, but not gonna lie, nothing about that trailer
stands out
at all.
Yeah, I'm excited because of the name. And
yeah,
that's
yeah. The gameplay is more like over the shoulder, kinda actiony.
Yeah, I
but
think
also,
but
also
kinda calmness
like Uncharted-esque,
yeah, like
cinematic.
Definitely like an Uncharted feel to it.
Yeah. Like
which
you,
is good.
Okay,
all
guys,
right,
so real quick, we're going to show off some of the Days Gone gameplay because the Days Gone trailer was the second thing that they showed. They circled back to Days Gone at the end of the conference and showed off this extended gameplay demo.
Which is a lot better than the trailer.
Yeah, it really shows like what the game's all about.
Yeah. Also, you can literally do that with an oil filter.
Yeah,
yes.
you can scavenge for parts, it looks like. For
but
all
I mean
in
real
place.
Life.
Yeah, that's a real thing.
Yeah, Sony's teaching you kids how to silence your pistols.
How to create a silencer.
Get your local oil filter and put it over your gun.
Yeah, so... Yeah, here's kind of our first look at the monsters of this world. I wouldn't call them zombies. They don't look like zombies. They're clearly former humans, but like they're attacking people. They look like more like
well, that was an animal attack too. There was like a dead dog.
Yeah, yeah, that was
there
a dead,
was, like,
wolf.
A dead wolf. So yeah, it's like they're attacking everything.
Yeah, so it looks like they're they seem just like maybe they're just
ooh
like rage virus victims, something
yeah,
kind of
I mean,
thing.
You see, like the hair is gone on them.
The
so
children of the forest.
They look like fucking golems, honestly. Like,
well, that one. Especially.
That first one looks like it just.
The
looks
first
like
one especially looks like a golem.
Yeah, but the
thing
other ones look a lot more human.
Yeah, they
yeah
definitely.
They jump.
They don't look so
a little
desiccated
less
too.
Like, yeah,
there might be variations in them, like How Left 4 Dead. You know, obviously yeah different zombies and all that. But if you look at the sides, they look more like zombies now. They're not zombies, but they look more like
yeah
them.
Well, especially from above, like, because they have that, like, shambly kind of vibe going on.
Yeah, definitely the
so
World
I guess,
War
like,
Z shamble kind of
these,
thing.
Definitely,
zombie
definitely looks like World War Z.
Like, dissolve or devolve into, like, those golem things.
They could over time. Kind of, like,
or maybe
red.
That's a child.
Maybe.
Like, who knows, you know? It's like.
And this is the part
oh
that I got
oh, this
a, lot
part
of,
was extreme
a lot of fun out of. Because, he probably broke his leg and he's screaming. Yeah.
Oh yeah, the leg's definitely broken.
Yeah.
Oh,
he just save the bullets.
Friggin' eat him.
Smart guy.
But also needs the head start.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh. See, this is what I was saying why it's kind of like Uncharted, where it's like, it seems like you're playing a movie.
Just because they're like reactionary kind of cinematic things happening.
Yeah. Also, this over the shoulder is pretty much.
Yeah, the flow of them is beautiful, too. The way that they, like, shamble over each other and everything.
Oh, yeah, it's ridiculous.
And it's interesting because it seems like you actually have to shoot at them to slow them down. Like, you have to, like, create a level of them to, like, collapse, like, to trip over one another to get away.
Because it does look like they do that to each other.
Yeah, so it looks like you're constantly going to be overwhelmed with enemies.
I remember when I first saw this, I was like, yeah, shoot at the 5,000 people, right? And it's like, no, that actually works.
And that's the thing I think is interesting, too, that it will definitely set this apart from The Last of Us, is that The Last of Us was definitely, like, it wanted you to think more about killing. Whereas, like,
please,
this definitely seems, it's just like, run and gun and run the fuck away!
If there
like,
was times you had 10 bullets in your magazine, you were like, I am set!
Yeah.
It's like, oh my
like,
god.
This guy's just unloading bullets.
Yeah, for real.
So,
it's just fucking ridiculous.
Probably knew this kind of things would happen, you know?
Dude, shit is fucking ridiculous.
Yeah, breaking the bridge.
But yeah, so that's the game.
That's how you get to the smoldering lake.
Yeah, there's two more. The climax is he gets stuck at the top, and we don't know how he's going to get away. So, boom.
But yeah, that's...
They actually have a page on a Tolkien, and giant eagles come to save him.
Wow.
But
we
yeah,
got
so...
Two games already,
I still feel
oh,
kind
yeah.
of...
Oh, boy.
Eh. About it. Like,
it's
it looks
okay.
fun. It looks
it's
cool,
okay.
and it doesn't look like anything I'm... interested in.
I hear you.
Yeah. And
like, nothing that's good, fresh that's grabbing
nothing
you.
Nothing that's fresh or new, and it's like, it's cool the way they're using zombies and like using the hardware to do stuff we couldn't do in the last gen.
Right.
But like, it's still a, you know, post zombie apocalypse fucking Walking Dead look at what if we're the real monsters.
Right. So we'll see.
Yeah. And like
Sony Ben's, like you said, it's got a
yeah.
good pedigree,
it's,
so I'm excited about it because of that.
The pedigree's interesting.
If it was somebody else's game, I think I'd be more inclined to agree with you, though.
Yeah. If Ubi had announced that, I would have been like,
oh, no.
Right.
Bad. Bad. It's like
yeah.
it's Assassin's Creed with guns.
But the fact that it's, yeah,
like
the fact that it's a Sony first party definitely, to me, is...
It gives a little bit of faith.
Well, yeah, it shows that it's probably going to be good.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, and you might be sold on it because it's a good game, not because the
yeah.
setting is interesting.
Yeah.
Which, I'm fine with that.
Yeah,
you know, like
I've built zero hype. We'll see.
Yeah, I hear that. So yeah, the next thing they confirmed, The Last Guardian is being released on October 25th.
Sure.
I'll maybe. Believe it when I see
that,
it.
That gives them four whole months, and
to
from right now, 11 days to put it off for another 7 years.
Yeah, that's
yeah.
okay.
Is this the video game equivalent of Chinese Democracy? By
yeah.
Government?
Yes.
And it's like, it's coming out!
And
like,
this game was announced
out
the PS3 launch title.
Later.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
So,
yeah, we'll
low
see.
Expectations, I'll believe it. Comes out when we see it. We'll talk about it
I
when
mean,
it's actually a real game.
When it
yeah.
when it comes out, I'm really hyped, because it's the studio, or it's the game Iko's been working on since Shadow of the Colossus, which
right.
is 11 years old at this point, I think.
Yes.
Wow.
It's 11 years old, and that game still looks fucking awesome.
So good. Then we get to Horizon Zero.
Which is so exciting. Oh my god, this game looks so cool.
That is.
So the notes we had for this, just to give you a little preview, Pete said he's gonna throw up.
No, that's not this.
That's not this. Okay,
no.
Is it this? Oh, no, never mind.
That's not horror VR game, yeah.
Oh, alright.
No, this is, so, again, if you haven't heard of it, Horizon is, the new
Ages.
Game by Guerrilla Studios.
Oh, no!
There we go. Is the new game by Guerrilla Studios, who are the team responsible for Killzone for the last, like, 10 fucking years. You play as this young woman, in a world where Earth has been... our society has, like, come and gone. It's been retaken by nature, and humans have kind of returned to, like, a feudal way of living, but they still have...
Oh, tribal.
Yeah, tribal. Excuse me, not feudal. And they still have, like, little, like, bits of technology.
It's probably something along the lines of, like, they don't know ever how to remake it. Or what it even does, just, it does what it does.
It reminds me of, like, how some of the Final Fantasy games play out. Like, I know Final Fantasy X was like that, where they have tech from, like, the old ones.
Right. And
oh,
like,
yeah.
I mean, you see, everything that they've been building in this is, like, made out of wood, and, like, they
right.
haven't made anything with metal.
No, but they have, like, their weapons, like, she has a bow, but, like, her bows, I think some of them are explosive and stuff like that. So, like, they clearly have some technology.
Yeah, there's definitely some high tech that she has.
But I think the whole thing is that, like, what you're about to see in a second is the world is overrun by these machine creatures, and I think all they scavenge parts from them to build
weapons. Yeah, they do.
And stuff.
Yeah.
So
it's interesting, because like Native American tribes, you know, they would take out obviously bison and use every part.
Right.
They're gonna take out these machines, which are essentially.
And here you
nature.
Can see there's like components
and
stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The machines are now like what the equivalent of nature almost, because they're.
I mean, they are.
Yeah, I mean, but that's... They're docile.
And that's the weird thing is we haven't... Not all of them, but
these
ones.
Well, I mean,
ones,
this one. I'm saying, so the fact that they would even... I mean, obviously, you shoot it, it's going to be mean. But the fact that, like, you coexist with that is very strange. You
know? It's also interesting to see, like, I haven't seen any organic creatures.
This one right there was a boar. It was just on the
show. Oh, there was?
So, like,
okay, I missed that.
Eat?
I was going to say,
like,
Thompson,
no
just
organic
said,
creatures.
Thompson just said that he
yeah,
saw a boar.
Oh,
so,
okay.
Yeah,
yeah, no, there's
okay,
like,
and here's one.
Yeah, there's, like, or, like, whatever that is.
Yeah,
but,
so there's still nature.
But it's just... Like,
there's a rabbit.
Oh, little rabbit! Little bunny friend! I have a bunny
Not
friend!
Not going to lie, I, knowing only that this game looks dope, this
yeah.
game has a terrible title.
What?
Horizon?
Horizon
Zero
Dawn?
Yeah.
Alright, okay.
Sounds like it's going to be a Division knockoff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Knowing only the title about it...
And that's the other thing is...
Yeah, we figured out that they can be corrupted. I have no idea what that means.
It's got a
but
serious
they're
Princess
just
Mononoke
like,
vibe.
They're just basically...
A what?
Oh, yeah.
What'd you say?
Serious Princess Mononoke vibe.
Oh,
huh,
yeah, yeah,
I
definitely.
I see that.
Definitely.
Ashitaka!
So then this is really cool.
I love anime too much to make fun of that.
There's dialogue wheels. Yes, and something worse. A demon. Yeah, this game looks beautiful.
And look at how many options you could potentially have on that wheel.
It looks like six. Maybe eight.
I think eight.
Yeah,
I think that'd be eight. I mean, there's only three, obviously, for that, but the limits are eight.
But, dude, I, like,
maybe six, I don't know.
The hype is real for this game.
Absolutely.
Like, this is the first Sony first-party game. Excuse me. The first Sony first-party game that's going to come out on PS4 that's actually, like, an original IP, you know? And it looks so good. Like... I'd be excited if it looked half as good. And it looks really fun.
The only thing that kind of bothers me now is retroactively thinking about God of War. It's like, damn, it's kind of like what this is, just this has more of it.
In terms of, like,
gameplay, fighting and all that? Like,
well,
the
no,
camera
the
angle.
Fighting's completely
yeah,
different.
The fighting's legendary.
No, no,
the
no.
Perspective
it's
the perspective is
the perspective. I'm not saying, like...
Yeah. Oh, you just mean, like, the third-person action.
Yeah. It's over the,
yeah.
over the shoulder
yeah.
stuff, yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. You know
oh,
what I mean?
A hype level just went from, like... 10 to 7, one of the tabs in her menu there was crafting.
Yeah, you craft. So you made your own traps? I think
you
sort of
Yeah,
before.
You have to do this stuff.
That's why I said, like, The Last
I fucking
of Us
hate
is a big
that.
One. Nah, there's materials in the animals for a reason.
Yeah, but, like...
Yeah, that's it's cool setting, and, like, if it's for you, that's fine, but... I hate crafting in action games.
Really?
Yeah, but I'm sure it's not mandatory.
No, it's like traps and stuff, little explosive shells.
Yeah.
It's
I mean,
not, it's
I
not
also,
like you need to make a house.
Also,
I agree with you where I also don't really like crafting in general in most games, but I don't think it's going to be enough to detract.
Like,
yeah, I mean, it's just a waste of time. I would rather just like get the
I'd
items
rather
that
play
I need.
The game and just have the game give me those items.
Yeah, I agree.
I like Last of Us because you had an item that could be made into two items. You had to choose, did you want bandages or first aid kits? And or Molotovs or like, offensive
yeah.
or defensive items. And that's
See,
why I like that.
In a game like that, I think it really makes sense because resource management in an apocalyptic game is like...
This is probably the
yeah.
same.
But I have to say, like, I don't think that the crafting will get in the way of this. I think if anything, like, the crafting will probably be the way that it is in like the majority of like Ubisoft games, where it's like, yeah, you can craft, but you don't necessarily need to.
Right. I mean, that's what I said. It's like more equipment or anything than it, and that is neat.
Oh my god, that thing looks insane.
It's a corruptor. Here we go. See, it corrupted. Nice.
Oh, and you did.
Yeah, the combat
Ooh.
Looks really cool.
Yeah, dude, it looks insane.
It's a trap.
Oh.
Nice.
Oh, that's so cool.
Yeah, you can knock it
See?
Down.
Crafting's important.
Crafting kicks ass,
no,
though.
No, or you can just get traps.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's kind of dumb, though. I don't know, just fine. Like, hey, look, explosive traps just laying on the ground.
Ah, just like, you know, like
it,
a,
it makes
a
more
hub
sense.
Somewhere where you, like, go and have to buy things.
I'd rather
like,
scavenge
system.
The parts and then craft
Yeah,
them.
I would do that.
Over. Also, it's cool that you can summon your ride.
Yeah.
Get some Legend of Zelda-esque horse bowing right now.
I was actually... That looked a lot like Shadow of Colossus to me. you know, you whistle, your horse comes, and then you're riding your horse and shooting at a giant monster.
I mean, I know you guys haven't seen it yet, but this reminds me of, like, a scene from The Legend of Zelda, the new one.
The horse is dead.
It was a bull.
It was a broadhead, thank you?
Yeah.
Whatever. Horse, whatever.
I like this part. I like the grappling things that you have to actually pin it to the ground.
Yeah, I think that's, like, it's neat. It's, and, like, you have to, like, pin it in strategic places because it can actually, like, pull apart and stuff. It's gonna try.
Yeah. And it's down.
Boom.
Boom, baby.
Oh, just, like, shit, dude.
No, it's like its core came out.
Oh.
He, like, overheated it or something. I don't know.
Bam!
Yeah. Oh yeah. So that's a corruptor.
That's Horizon Zero Dawn.
Yeah, I mean,
woof.
Yeah, that's just a lot to take in.
Yeah, we got through like the whole thing because I'm really excited about that game.
I'm really excited about that game. I still think that game needs a better title.
It kind of does.
It's too late, but you're right. I mean, I'll counteract with that I said the exact same thing about Overwatch until I played it, and then it became unforgettable. It's like, a bad name is a definite detractor, but if the game is cool enough and visually memorable enough, we'll get past it.
Yeah, no, it's like, I'm not interested in the game because of the title.
No, you're totally right, though.
It's a terrible fucking title.
Yeah, it's generic as fuck. And for how, like, interesting that game is, like...
It sounds like a young adult novel.
It sounds purposely generic, is, I think, the problem.
I want something with, like, a little more intrigue.
Yeah.
Like, Event Horizon.
Oh, we can go past time and space and find hell itself.
Oh, man. But, yeah, so I'm super hyped about Horizon Zero Dawn. Comes out in, it got pushed back to 2017 Q1. So take your time with that shit, Gorilla. It looks dope.
Yeah.
Can't wait to play it. So the next game, another Sony original, is Detroit Become Human.
Oh, damn.
I too, have played fucking Deus Ex Human Revolution.
Heavy Rain!
This game tugs at your heartstrings.
Yeah, so
man.
Detroit...
Even the trailer is rough.
Detroit Become Human is the new game by the creators of it's Quantic Dream, creators of Heavy Rain, and that other game that is way less popular than Heavy Rain. Totally blanking on it right now. It's got Willem Dafoe and what's her name? Juno.
Beyond Two Souls.
Beyond Two Souls. Thank you.
That game was bad.
Yeah, it was.
Was it?
That's unfortunate.
That's the resounding opinion. Haven't played it.
That game was like bad.
So here's the thing. You play this android. You're some kind of cop. There's obviously some human android. I don't know, some tension between the androids and the humans. And you show up here trying to get some information about this robot man.
Setting looks interesting.
Yeah, I'm always into games with real consequences and like where there's like a moral quandary like this, like man versus machine.
The one thing I noticed was interesting, he looked at the iPad, stuff. Right? And the guy with the gun in the iPad, the circle on his head was still blue and now it's red.
Yeah.
I don't know if that means anything. Maybe he got like free will or something. Maybe it's like free will.
Oh,
do what
he
wants.
I never noticed that.
Because, it's like, hey, previous thing with the child, he had a blue thing on
his face. Interested what his relationship is to the child prior to this.
He's the stepdad or whatever.
Can robots be stepdads?
Yeah, why not? He had the kid in the
Can robots be stepdads? The Peter Messi story.
That depends on if he got the right questions right. They both wouldn't have fallen down, would they? Because,
so now,
oh man, they could have been different.
Things could have been different.
Now they're going to show you
literally
how it goes.
The campaign slogan for Rogue Trader, things could have gone different.
So the whole way this plays out is you come in, it in a lot of ways it looks like it has some of the same mechanics as L.A. Noire, but good. Like you have to come in, examine the crime scene, and then use that information.
L.A. Noire was good.
L.A. Noire was like
LA Noir
so was close to good.
It was too long, but it was good. I liked it a lot.
It's good adjacent.
I... I don't know. Beyond Two Souls was bad, and I didn't like Heavy Rain very much.
Wow. Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, Heavy Rain's one of the ones that's like... I haven't played either of them because I was late to the PS3 party.
Jesus, we're going to play Heavy Rain.
I really want to. before this comes out. They're doing a re-release of it, actually. Yeah, there's...
Just look at how many options for one scene. One scene! So many times. So many ways.
Oh.
Be full Paragon.
Yeah.
Oh, that's good. It's good to see.
I trust you. Gets filled with lead.
Yep. Nice.
So,
yeah.
There you go. That's Detroit.
Keanu Reeves.
My name is Neo. And I am the one.
It's kind of like...
That seems awesome.
It looks interesting in a way that like Heavy Rain didn't.
Yeah, it looks
but
like everything good about it and more.
I'm not crazy.
And then plus androids.
Wow.
Wow.
Andy, not... And thrilled
yeah,
all
he's
by the Sony
not feeling anything so
kid buys on
I'm
Xbox.
Not, I'm really about Horizon Zero Dawn. I just think it needs a better title.
Yeah.
And God of War looks interesting for God of War.
Yeah.
But Detroit Become Human looks cool, but their track record is such that I'm not going to be hyped till it's good.
I understand that. I mean, they have one one success and one failure, so
yeah,
that's fair.
I didn't play the failure, so I can't really
yeah.
say. Well...
Yeah, you
that's,
don't like
that's
the
where we disagree.
Okay. Which is weird, because I usually like those kind of games. Like, I'm big on Telltale.
I know
yeah,
you would,
I'm surprised
yeah.
you don't,
that's
you
why
don't
I'm
like
surprised
that
you didn't like it, yeah.
But yeah, so after that, they went into this whole big breakdown on what's coming to Sony VR. They showed off a new horror game that we ended up figuring out was actually Resident Evil Biohazard.
It doesn't look
Woo!
Like Resident Evil until the last second. It's just
yeah.
like Resident Evil 7 sitting
Fuck
here.
Yes.
What?
And
well, no,
so
hype for that.
I don't think it's 7. I think that was Resident Evil Biohazard. I think that's a separate thing. And
but it
then,
has a VII. That's a 7.
Was the, okay, maybe that is.
Biohazard's just
Biohazard's
the Japanese
name
for the franchise.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
excuse
yeah.
me then.
Resident Evil is the American name, and Biohazard is the Japanese name.
I didn't know that. That's what I'm saying.
Hazard.
So anyway, apparently all of Resident Evil 7 is playable on Sony VR.
Which
that's pretty cool.
Cool.
Sure. Comes out October 13th, 2016.
Seen zero gameplay. We have no idea if it's good.
Yeah, so it's like, I know. Oh, I'm sorry. That's on
the
game.
The VR.
I meant, yeah, Sony VR comes out on October 13th, which I think, you know.
The game comes out around there.
I think all the
around
games.
Around the same time.
Most of the games
yeah,
are coming out
before
the VR.
They said there are going to be 50 games at launch.
Games, yeah.
And it looks like Resident Evil's one of them.
The VR trend and how everyone's embracing it confuses me. Because, like, I don't want to buy a console, then spend more than the price of the console now on an accessory for the console.
Oh, no, I agree. That's why I got Pete
yeah.
one, so
right.
he exists.
Yeah.
I think the issue is, like, it is an accessory, but I think you do have to look at it more of, like, it is kind of like its own console. It's like, there are games that are only, you know, it's like, Sony VR games are only Sony VR games, you know, so it's...
But you have to have a PS4 for them, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So, I mean, otherwise, you know. By that logic, though, even if you buy a PS4 and you don't own one, and then you also buy Sony VR, it's still less than the cost of any of the VR competitors.
Is it?
Yeah, because... If you use the same logic of you still need a PS4 to run it, then you need a computer that's capable of running Oculus or Vive, which is over $1,000 computer, easy.
Usually $1,500 now.
Yeah,
that's your optimal
to run it well.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. So
it's just like I don't know. I'm not excited enough about the idea of VR.
Sure.
To like have any of this make sense to me. I feel like the old man left behind.
No. I'm
no,
totally...
No, dude, I totally feel
I'm
you.
I'm completely there with you, and so the only reason I'm okay with it is because he bought one.
Yeah,
and
I'd be...
I wouldn't even consider buying one if it wasn't for Pete.
See, I'd be a lot less inclined to be, like, I wouldn't be a Gen 1 adopter if we didn't have a channel. You know,
it's for you guys.
Yeah, really.
It's
for
you.
That's our job, is to, like, play games and talk about games and, like, explore what's new. So I want to be informed about VR. I don't want to, like, have my opinion be, I'm not excited about VR because I haven't tried it. If I don't like it, I want to not like it because it's not good. You know?
Yeah.
I just hope you didn't spend $400 to say it's not good.
That's rough.
We'll see. I don't really care. Like, I think at the end of the day, it'll be a cool relic to have both one of the first commercial
like
VR devices either way.
It's the Nintendo one with the red
Virtual Boy?
Yeah.
Like, Virtual Boy.
Dude, if I owned a Virtual Boy right now, though, I would be so hype on that. Like, are you kidding me? Yeah, it would be so cool to still own a Virtual Boy.
So this is the VR game that is the most hype.
Yeah, so that was the thing. They announced a few set of VR games. We're going to talk about each of them. This is the only one we decided we want to actually take a look at. It's called Farpoint.
Spaz, this is the one.
Oh, this is the one. I literally, after watching this set, my dick just went inside me.
Yeah. Because other people felt like they wanted to throw up.
Yeah.
I was that other people.
Yeah.
Reformatted for non-VR display.
Yeah, it is worth knowing that this isn't exactly what it would look like for you, but it's very clearly VR because you can see the way the camera's moving.
Yeah. It'll look a little shakier after they post effect it back
this
to a normal display.
Disoriented.
Because it has the sides more so to get, so. Everything's unknown.
You know what this kind of reminds me of? Starship Troopers.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
But,
just gonna see the worms just coming out of the
Dune?
Ground.
Dune? Please.
Legitimately giving me a headache.
Really?
Yeah, it's just
How shaky it is?
Yep.
It wouldn't look like that when you're like actually wearing it though.
Those are the kinds of problems that VR has to solve though for sure.
Yeah. Yep, there you go.
Yeah, this was the thing that
that's the thing.
Terrified me to my very core.
That's not free in any possible it's there.
I can't wait to be puked on by a spider in real time. So yeah, that's Farpoint.
There you go. That
wow.
Really good. But
for all those people who are afraid of spiders.
Yeah, man.
like me.
Okay, yeah, that's that. Yeah, so that was the one game we chose to show because otherwise we'd literally be looking at like every trailer Sony put out. Also in the VR section, they announced that Battlefront 2 is going to have an X-Wing VR mission, which looks really cool. Check out the trailer for that. Batman Arkham VR is coming in October 2016.
They
gave us no information about
just
what that is.
It's just voiceover with a Batman mask.
Yeah, like, I have no idea. No idea if it's its own game, if it's an Arkham Knight add-on. We have no idea. Then there's Final Fantasy 15 VR experience, which is pretty interesting. It lets you play as a new character called, what is it, Prompto? And it essentially turns the game into an FPS. I don't really agree with that on its... I don't agree with
that
on its
gun
face.
And you shoot the monsters with your gun, because now we're Call of Duty and Final Fantasy.
That being said, I do think it's an interesting... way to try to expand on a game with VR, like to add a character that's VR specific or something.
It's
like
really
that.
Interesting, that's for sure.
Thompson doesn't seem happy about this at all.
I mean, I agree that it's a horrible move for Final Fantasy. I do think it's a cool idea. I think it could work well with other games.
Yeah,
so,
that's fair.
We already had those kinds of games. They were called Time Crisis.
Speaking of Call of Duty.
Oh my god.
So yeah, speaking of Call of Duty, Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, they showed that off, and we had no idea what it was until they showed the logo at the end, and all the three of us who watched it live here together, me, Thompson, and Spaz, were like, wow, this game looks really cool.
Call of Duty is cool after 6 years of not being cool.
So yeah, it's weird. It's the first time in my life I've ever been actually interested in both Battlefield and fucking Call of Duty in a year. But whatever, they both look pretty cool.
Yeah,
I mean,
for real.
Like the space fights in this. Did you see this trailer?
Yeah,
it's like the fucking space combat was really neat.
You have a
just like dragging someone while in space and ripping their mask off.
You have a grappling hook and you can attach to anything. Stop.
Andy Brown's got his own popular opinion.
I do.
Hit us with it.
I largely think those are going to be QuickTime events in the campaign, and
you
it's going to be Call of Duty in space.
Maybe.
Could be.
It's not going to be a drastically changed game.
I really hope they're not QuickTime events.
You're also those are going to be like campaign specific events that don't accurately represent the multiplayer, which is
well,
what
they were in a fighter craft before that, and that wasn't a QuickTime event at least.
Yeah, they should.
So
like
there is like procedural
battles.
Fighting and
cool.
At least the placement of things in space, it can't be too static because you have to fly around. So
that being said, even if that is the case, I'm not going to play a Call of Duty multiplayer ever. Like that's not going to happen.
I'm not really big into the multiplayer anyway. Yeah. So
if this game could be like a Redbox game where I play through the campaign in fucking 8 hours or whatever, and it's a fun experience, like I'd be
yeah.
down for that.
It's not a
yeah.
pre-order title for me, but I'm definitely going
to
play it.
Yeah, I'd be down to rent it for sure. So they also announced Call of Duty Modern Warfare Remastered is on the way. And then they dropped a bomb that I never expected could ever have been real. But I'm super excited for it.
Pete was the most hyped for this.
I screamed at the top of my lungs. I really
yeah.
did. Crash Bandicoot 1, 2, and 3, the Naughty Dog trilogy, is being remastered for the PS4. Crash is also going to be appearing in Skylanders as like a, you know, whatever. If you know how Skylanders works, you buy a figure, you get levels and stuff.
It's an amiibo.
Yeah, basically. So, yeah, I'm so fucking excited to see the games get remastered. I hope that they play with mechanically how it plays a little bit similar to how they did the Ratchet remaster, because while I remember Crash fondly, nostalgically, those games do not hold up super well gameplay-wise.
Generally speaking, when they use like the term remaster, they're probably not gonna...
They don't change the gameplay at all.
Change the gameplay. It's gonna be that, but with a fresh coat of graphics.
Yeah, I think you're probably right that like...
It's just gonna be the HD collection.
Or like an HD collection. Mm-hmm. That being said, I will say though, I think one of the biggest like... reasons that game is so clunky is because it was a 3D platformer that was built on a D-pad. So if they literally just port that you can use analog stick control and give Crash 8-directional movement, like, you're
pretty
set.
Much the whole game.
The game's fine then.
Yeah, I think,
yeah.
Honestly, I think maybe not the whole reason, but a big part of the reason this is happening is just because everybody liked it in Uncharted.
I mean...
That section happens and everybody talked about it.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, Crash Bandicoot, remember that?
I wonder, I don't think it's, like, a because of,
and that's
but
why,
I bet that was a test of waters
kind
of move.
That's why they're not showing anything, is because it was well-received in there, and now they can say, oh, by the way, Crash!
Yeah, it's, like, just a thing. So, yeah, I mean, like, obviously, like, this deal with Activision has been, like, worked on for a while, though, because of, like, the other stuff that's coming with it.
Yeah.
So, like, it seems as though, like... I'm sure that was part of that conversation, though. Like, at least for, like, let's see what people think about this. So, I'm very excited about it. I don't necessarily think it means anything that, like, we'll get another Crash game in the future, but I don't really even necessarily need one. I would just love to be able to retread those games and, like, actually have them play the way I remember them. Yeah, as opposed to the way that they are.
Yeah.
So, I'm hype as shit about that. Don't even care. They also announced LEGO Star Wars Episode 7 is on the way. It's a Lego Star Wars game. It looks really fun. They all are fun. Play it.
Lego games are good.
No. I'm the first one who said that. But
now for the most exciting part.
Now for the strangest part.
Yeah. So
the Rockstar of video gaming, Kojima, showed us some crazy shit.
So Kojima fucking strolls in to just let this play. Kojima strolls into Sony's E3 conference like a motherfucking wrestler. It's just like fucking music playing, like all the lights like illuminating the pathway. He fucking comes up, strolls in like a boss, and announces this goddamn new game.
I have a game, and I know I said I had nothing, but
alright guys.
Look at these hands though.
So here's Norman Reedus and his baby.
He's so happy. Oh, look at Daryl.
He's not dirty enough to be Daryl.
I love you, Beth.
Too soon? No. I'm thinking
spoilers!
I'm thinking jokes that night.
I mean, too.
So this game is the weirdest thing ever, by the way.
Yeah, this makes no sense.
It's very, very Kojima.
And then baby hands.
Yep.
There's a thing that's weird about this.
The baby was a Metal Gear.
All of this is weird. What are you talking about?
No.
There's a thing that's weird about this? That's the thing.
I wanted
that's,
to point
that's
that out.
That's where the baby was ripped out.
And so when we said it was Norman Reedus' baby, we mean literally Norman Reedus birthed a child.
Yeah, somehow.
He had a C-section.
It's pretty nasty. I don't know how he did it. And he looks really mad.
Because they took his baby.
Who? Yeah. Who took
also,
his baby?
The weird robot,
you know,
man.
Those
robot
in
guys
sky.
In the sky.
Well, we don't know if they're robots.
What is this game about? No one knows. Why are all these fucking whales beaching themselves? No one knows.
So that's strange.
I hope. Well, I really hope that.
Also, I love how they gave a shout-out to the song and the thing. I remember when we saw this at first, I was like, is Kojima just announcing, like, this is just a music video for his new band?
Right?
Like,
oh, camera.
That would be awesome.
I really hope that this is good.
I do, too.
And not every other ex-celebrity in video game.
But it's Kojima, dude.
I know. That's why I'm giving it...
Oh, my God. Fuck off. Whatever. Death Stranding. That's the game.
Death Stranding.
Death Stranding. So that's Death Stranding. Kojima's new game.
Got it.
Yeah.
Looks.
It looks cool.
I mean, it looks like a Kojima game. We know nothing about it. We don't even know what it is, like, in terms of how it plays, but it's got Kojima's name on it, and Norman Reedus is in it, so I'm at least interested.
Salt. I don't care if it's bad, I'm still gonna buy it.
I mean, I'm gonna buy it out of morbid curiosity, even if it is bad. After that fucking trailer. You
for
kidding realsies. Me? The hell is that? The hell is this game about?
I'm sure we'll get more vague ones. None of them are going to be as good as his Metal Gear trailer from 2 years ago with fucking Nuclear. I don't know if you ever saw that trailer. It's the best video game trailer I ever saw.
Probably. Was it?
It's just like Kiefer Sutherland as Big Boss,
yeah.
As Solid Snake.
Yeah,
with the music being like,
that.
I'm Nuclear! It's so good.
So that's... It's a thing. It's a game.
Yeah,
it's happening.
It's a game that's happening. It exists.
So, just real quick, like, let's take loosest bets imaginable so we can reminisce on this. When do you think that game comes out?
2018.
I'd say 2018. At
PS5 launch title.
I'd say it's 2018 at the absolute earliest. I'd say if we're, like, actually, if I really think, probably 2020. 4-year dev cycle for a Kojima game sounds about right.
Yeah.
And if it is 4 years, like... It could honestly be like a PS5 launch title. Like that wouldn't even
that
be crazy.
That would kill my heart.
Just saying, they didn't show a PS4 logo, did they?
No, they showed nothing. No
game. It's a game,
yeah.
And Sony's presenting it. That's all we know.
It's more of a concept right now, with a visual aid to go with it. It's like he has
I
a PowerPoint.
Want it though.
He's basically like, I got this great game, and here's a PowerPoint I made to show you.
I made a music video about it.
Yeah,
Norman
Reedus
had a baby.
And they're like, I'll make that game in a few years, guys.
One more. Fucking out of fucking nowhere trailer.
This was the biggest shock for me of the entire...
Next to Crash Bandicoot, even for you.
This was bigger.
This
was
bigger than Crash.
This was way bigger.
Insomniac doing this game? Like,
so
what?
Here's the thing, right? There's been a rumor that this game's been in development for a long time, but every single rumor was, it's Sucker Punch. Sucker Punch is making the game. And that makes sense. Sucker Punch made Infamous, they made Sly, they know how to do, like, third-person action superhero games. For it to be fucking Insomniac, I'm just like, what the fuck? This is so cool!
Oh, I could go for some pizza.
Shut up. They don't have good pizza in Queens.
Whoa.
They do.
It's still
not
New York.
Kidding. It's, yeah.
But wait, real quick.
It's still not Pennsylvania.
I really like this suit.
The suit's an interesting... It looks really good.
Like,
boom. Also, like, looks really, we know nothing about this game.
Oh, yeah, that's true. But, like, if any level of, like, how you're moving and how these fights play out is actually how they play out, like, some of this is in engine. This is all pre-rendered, but the fighting and stuff looks like it's in engine.
Ugh. Looks good. Spider-Man games are always fun.
Iron Man.
Spider-Man games are not always fun.
No,
yeah, no, that
is. I have played Spider-Man Shattered Dimensions.
That game's actually good.
It's not bad, man.
Wait, no, it's
you're the one after it.
The one after that.
Yeah, that's the one you're thinking of.
Which one was that? Because I don't remember.
It's the garbage game where you're going back and forth as Peter and Spider-Man 2099.
It's literally like if they, it's like Shattered Dimensions 2, essentially. But instead of it being Shattered Dimensions 2, they're like, okay, what if we took what worked about Shattered Dimensions and cut half of the characters out and then make it bad?
Okay.
And that's that game.
I didn't play it, so there you go.
It's like a boring, just like... You don't do Spider-Man stuff, you run down a hallway beating guys up.
But I will say...
And occasionally stick to the ceiling.
Excluding that one game, Spider-Man games are like pizza. It's that even the worst one is like still pretty alright.
like, the Spider-Man 2, like, the Spider-Man movie games, those were all really good. And the ones before that on the PlayStation 1, like, that one was really cool.
Spider-Man 2 for the PS2, still the all-time best Spider-Man game.
Ultimate Spider-Man. I agree with you. I think that's number 2, though. This is gonna be number 1, though. I'm calling it right now. If this game is bad, I'll fucking lie about it. I don't even care. I'm gonna will myself to like this game.
Wow. At least he's honest, everybody.
Oh, God.
And then Sony went back to Days Gone, but we showed you that already.
Yeah, so that wraps up our coverage of the Sony conference.
Yeah, that's...
So what do you think?
About Nintendo at some point?
Tell us what you think of Sony and all the things that you saw.
Yeah, in the comments below, or hit us up on Twitter.
If you do, I'll give you $1.
Yeah, and I will say, like, I'm just for, like, overall comments on the conference, like, we've kind of been doing for everyone, I thought Sony, like...
Killed it.
I think they have the best announcements of the conference. They were the only people that actually had surprises. And in terms of pacing, it was firing on all fucking cylinders the entire
time.
It
starts off with God of War. Gotta throw my unpopular opinion in.
Yeah,
as unpopular opinion, Sandy Brown. I'm not gonna, like, shit on Sony's conference. I like Sony's conference a lot. I think Microsoft had the better conference.
Okay.
I liked what Microsoft is doing. Like, Sony definitely had more games to show. Microsoft had more Xbox to show, if that makes sense.
That's fair, and I would say I don't think Sony beat them by a wide margin, so I don't even think that's, like, an unpopular opinion.
Yeah.
I think it's
Microsoft,
do you want more?
Is doing more interesting things, I think, than Sony has. Hey, we have a shit ton of games and some VR.
I mean, as
some of these games are going to look cool at, like, everybody.
Yeah.
Like, if there's something for everybody here, or Microsoft didn't, you know, show as much of that.
Yeah.
But there's a game for everyone in this press conference also means there's a game that's not for everyone. Press
That's true. And I think that's Sony's MO, is they try to give everyone 3 things at each show, and as long as they accomplish that, they're happy. And they got us this, I think, for sure. Like, there's enough here that I think you're going to be excited about at least 1 or 2 of these games.
And as a console gamer,
sorry, Spaz.
It doesn't...
You just lost the rest of the room.
No. No. Let it make a split.
But, you know, like, I'm excited about the games. Like, I know... Microsoft is doing a lot of stuff with the hardware and all that, but it's like, I play games because I enjoy the games. Like, I don't, you know, like, I don't need the most interesting interface or crazy things I can do with the systems. Like, I just want to play the video game.
So, I'm of 2 minds here. I agree with you overall, and that's why Sony's conference speaks to me more, and that's why Sony's conferences over the last few years have generally been my pick of the show. I will say, to Andy's point, though, I think, like, a good press conference has a balance of both of those things. Project Scorpio. Yeah, I think Project Scorpio is going to be a game changer, not just for Microsoft, but maybe for the entire console space.
Damn.
And I think it's going to have way more of an impact than the Neo, just based on, like, how we've seen these two, how they're presenting them. Granted, I don't know enough. I'm speculating. But
so
that's my
Sony
read.
Sony seemed defensive about the Neo when the leaks happened, and we're doing this, but it's a...
Microsoft was totally
Microsoft
confident.
Is, fuck you, this is going to be great, and you're going to fucking like it.
Yeah, and you're going to buy it because it's awesome.
Yeah.
You know?
And Sony's very really, like, you don't have to buy it, but if you want to buy a new one, like, this is the product for you.
No, and, like, that hedging, I think, fucked with their messaging, and it made it look weak, and I think, like, I agree with Andy, where, like, Scorpio, and maybe it is because I don't own an Xbox One, too, so maybe I'm biased, but, like, Scorpio came out of the gate, and it's like, you want this.
You have an Xbox One already? Fuck you, you still want this.
Yeah, and it's like, you don't need it, but you want it.
You bought an Xbox One last week? I still want this.
And Sony's entire thing is like, you already have a PS4, you don't need it, don't worry about it, it's going to be the same. And it's not going to be the same, don't tell me it's going to be the same.
It's like, you can play your games in 4K now, but, like, it's cool, everything's still going to be the same, you're not going to lose anything by not having this.
Right. And Microsoft did that in a way that showed confidence.
Yeah, Microsoft is like, yeah, I guess if you want backwards compatibility, it's there.
But
you're going to want it, trust me.
Right. So, all that being said, though, I still have to walk away. Sony absolutely has press conference of the show for me, I think. All of the things I'm most excited about out of E3 this year came from Sony's conference.
None of Sony's games, like, spoke to me in the way that Microsoft's games did.
Okay.
Like, Sea of Thieves looks fucking dope. And I'm not, like, Spider-Man out of nowhere is really cool.
Yeah.
And I'm excited for the Spider-Man game. But, like...
Sea of Thieves looks fucking tight.
Sea of Thieves looks tight. Scalebound looks cool.
Recore looks
amazing. Fucking
oh,
awesome.
Oh, yeah, Recore.
Yeah.
But, like...
Really good.
Days Gone... I'm cautiously optimistic about for the pedigree. Detroit Become Human. I would be way more excited about if it wasn't for the pedigree.
Right.
God of War. God of War.
Horizon, we can all agree, looks cool.
Farpoint.
Yeah.
Good. So here's my thing, right?
Spiders.
I think you're right, or not right. I think what it is that, like, it's what flavor do you want?
Yeah,
do you want McDonald's or Burger King? Yeah. You know, and like, for this year, you're picking Burger King, right? Cool. And I think what is so great about this year at E3 is that, like, we have to have that conversation.
Yeah.
Both of these companies are the two biggest players. They had the two greatest press conferences, and both of them have a really exciting next 2 years ahead of them.
Oh, absolutely.
And that's all we can ask for.
Yeah. Do we know anything more about Spider-Man other than the trailer?
No.
That's it.
We also
it's
want
called
to take guesses
Spider-Man.
On when Spider-Man comes out.
2020.
Next year. At some point.
I think 2018 is a safe bet.
Within 6 months of the movie is where I'm going to call it.
Yeah. So
definitely.
I think 2018 is a safe bet for, like, latest. I think 2017 is more likely because you're right, they're going to want to time it for the movie. I think... Because,
like, as big of a name as Sony is, Disney still gets to push Sony around on their release dates.
Sure. And I do think, though... They've probably been working on this for a while.
Yeah.
Because the rumor's been circulating for a while. Insomniac has more than one team. So, and it's, again, from what we've seen, it looks like the engine is pretty far along. They're done with art assets, it looks like. So, like, the game looks like it's a decent amount of the way done.
It's not like the Mass Effect trailer where it looks like...
We're like half of the...
talking.
Yeah, half of the trailer is people talking and showing them making fucking models and stuff, you know? So, like, this doesn't... It looks like it's pretty far along.
Yeah.
I would say a year from now wouldn't be crazy, which that would be when Homecoming's out, is next summer.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I hope.
That's not really wood.
It is.
It's real wood.
Yeah,
it's real wood. To you.
No way.
I don't know, whatever.
It's like plywood.
He's a master of wood.
So guys, I think we already did an outro, but we talked more. So that wraps it up for our Sony coverage of E3 this year. We're going to be getting together again tomorrow for Nintendo, so come and check that out. We're going to talk about Legend of Zelda, Pokemon Sun and Moon.
And anything else they decide to talk
about. Yeah, right, whatever else comes out from the day. So
talk about trees and houses.
Yeah, if you like the video, please like
maybe
it.
Maybe they'll talk about...
Share it with your friends and subscribe to the channel.
What's up? I was going to say maybe we'll talk about their fucking mobile games.
Yeah.
I mean,
probably not though.
You don't want to hear about Fire Emblem?
I don't
want to
hear about fucking free to play Fire Emblem.
No?
Fucking pay $3 and your guy doesn't die.
Yep, your best
you
friend
died.
You want to save their life for $5?
No, just not going to let them die.
No, you let everyone die.
Anyway, see you tomorrow.
Bye.